Gyronix.
In this lecture, we'll be solving quadratic equations, and this will be our topic outline. First, we'll discuss what is a rational expression, the standard form of quadratic equation, and quadratic formula. Okay, first is the rational expression. So this is a mathematical expression that can be represented in a fractional form. Okay, so fraction. Example is 21 over 45. Okay, so we are asked to simplify this rational expression, 21 over 45, by reducing to lowest terms. So the process in reducing to lowest terms the rational expression is we factored out the numerator and denominator. So we are aiming to have that common factor so that we can cancel that out. So for example, 21 can be represented as 3 times 7. So this is the factor of 21. So 45 can be also factored as 3 times 15, right? So we have now common factor, which is 3. So we can cancel this out. And that will give us the simplified version of this rational expression, which is 7 over 15. 7 over 15 is also equal to 21 over 45, only in simplified form. Okay, so you get the idea. Again, you factor the numerator, then you also factor the denominator and cancel out the common factor. Okay, so let's apply that concept in the next example. So again, we're asked to simplify this rational expression. So we have now 3x plus 6 as the numerator, and the denominator is a quadratic expression, x squared plus 4x plus 4. So the process is to factor out the numerator and factor out the denominator and cancel the common factor. Okay, so let's factor out first the numerator, which is 3x plus 6. So how to factor this out? Of course, we need to determine the greatest common factor. So the greatest common factor of 3x plus 6 is, of course, 3. So we can divide 3x by 3, which is, that is x, and 6 divided by 3 is 2. This will be the factor of the numerator, right? 3x plus 6 can also be represented as 3 times x plus 2. Next is we factor the denominator. So we have here quadratic expression. So we know how to factor out quadratic expression, right? Okay, so we have here a constant 4 and the middle term beside the x, another 4. So we'll find two numbers that when you multiply will give us 4. When we add will give us also 4. And obviously that is 2, right? So 2 plus 2 is 4. 2 times 2 is also 4. And this is the factor of the denominator, x plus 2 times x plus 2. So we have now common terms. So we can cancel out that x plus 2. And that remains 3 over x plus 2 as the answer. Okay, the next example is multiplying rational expression and dividing rational expression. So in multiplying rational expression, for example, we're asked to compute 4 over 3 times 2 over 5. So we simply multiply the numerator, 4 times 2, and we multiply the denominator, which is 3 times 5. So as simple as that. 4 times 2 is 8, 3 times 5 is 15. And that will give you the answer. So in dividing rational expression, for example, we are asked to divide 4 over 5. So this will be the numerator divided by 2 over 3, the denominator. Okay? So in dividing rational expression is we copy the numerator 4 over 5. Then we proceed to multiplication, provided that we get the reciprocal of the denominator. So the reciprocal of 2 over 3 is 3 over 2. Then we proceed to multiplication. So in multiplying rational expression, so simply we multiply the numerator, then we multiply the denominator. So 4 times 3 is 12, 5 times 2 is 10. And this rational expression we can reduce to lowest term, since 12 can be expressed as 2 times 6. And 10 can be expressed as 2 times 5. So we have common, which is 2. We can cancel that out. And the final answer is 6 over 5. So let's apply this concept in the next exercise. So we have now division of rational expression. Okay, this is the numerator. This is the denominator. Okay, so what do we do if we are dividing? Okay, so this is the numerator, x squared plus x over x plus 4. So we proceed to multiplication, provided that, okay, we get the reciprocal of the denominator, which is times x squared minus 16 over x plus 1. So we are now multiplying two rational expressions. So we can multiply numerator and we can multiply denominator. But first, before multiplying, so let's try to factor this out, x squared plus x, by determining the greatest common factor. So what can divide x squared plus x? Okay, so it can be divided by x. So x squared divided by x is x. Of course, x divided by x is 1. Okay, so that is the first factor. The numerator can be expressed as this one. Okay, x times x plus 1. Okay. So the next factor, x squared minus 16. So we can factor that out. So this is what? The difference of squares. Of course, 16 can be represented as 4 squared. So if you remember the formula for the difference of squares, okay, so we have a squared minus b squared is a minus b times a plus b. So x squared minus 4 squared is equivalent to x minus 4 times x plus 4. So this is the factor of the numerator for second factor. Okay, so let's write that out. Okay, we have x plus 4 times x minus 4 divided by x plus 1. Okay, so we have common now. Since we are multiplying both the numerator and the denominator, so x plus 1 can be cancelled out. So what else the common? X plus 4 and x plus 4. So what's left is x times x minus 4. And this is the answer. Okay, so by the way, we cancel this out. Since if you divide x plus 1 divided by x plus 1, that is what? 1. X plus 4 divided by x plus 4 also 1. Okay, so that's why we cancel that factor. But in subtracting or adding rational expression, we cannot just simply subtract the numerator and subtract the denominator. So we can't do that. Okay? So to subtract or add rational expression, the denominator must be the same or the denominator must be common to both terms. Okay, so we need to find that common denominator simply by multiplying the denominator. So we have 6 and 15. So simply multiply them. That is your common denominator. So 6 times 15 is 90. Okay? So the first term is 7 over 6. So again, it must be 90, the denominator. So how to make it 90? This is 6. Okay, so we multiply it by 15. Right? But of course, I cannot just multiply the denominator without multiplying the numerator. So it will change my expression if I'm going to multiply only the denominator. So this one, just like multiplying to 1, right? 15 over 15 is 1, just like 7 over 6 times 1. This part here will give me 90. 6 times 15 is 90, right? 7 times 15, the numerator, is 105. Take note, we can allow to multiply the numerator and denominator. So that is the rule for multiplying rational expression. Okay, so we have now our first term. The second term, the 4 over 15. So we need, of course, again, a common denominator, which is 90. So we have 15. Okay, we need what? 6, right? So 15 times 6, that will make my denominator 90. Of course, I cannot just multiply denominator by 6. I will also multiply the numerator by 6. So that it will not change my expression. So 4 times 6 is 24. Of course, 15 times 6 is 90. So we have now common denominator. So if you have common denominator, then you are allowed to subtract the numerator. But if it's not common, so you cannot subtract the numerator. Okay, so we have now common denominator. We can subtract. 105 minus 24 is 81 over 90. Okay, so next is we can further reduce this into lowest term. So 81 can be expressed as 9 times 9. 90 can be also expressed as 9 times 10. Okay, so we have common factor, 9. Can cancel that out. And the answer is 9 over 10. Again, in subtracting or adding rational expression, we cannot just simply add or subtract the numerator, then add or subtract the denominator, just like what we did in multiplying rational expression. So we cannot do that. So the denominator must have the same value or common, okay, just like this one, 90. So this one, we are using the common denominator, but the most efficient way is use the least common denominator. So how do we find the least common denominator? we need to factor out our denominator. So 6 can be factored out as 2 times 3, right? 15 can be factored out as 3 times 5. So we have now a repeating value. Okay, so if you have repeating value, you only take 1. So which means the least common denominator is 2 times 3 times 5. So we don't need 2, 3. Otherwise, you are just like multiplying 6 times 15. That is common denominator. So we are now finding the least common denominator. Okay, so we have 2 times 3 times 5. Again, we don't have to repeat this 2, 3. Okay, so we can apply the same concept. We have 7 over 6. So 6 can be expressed as, okay, 2 times 3. So we need what? Okay, 5. So which means we multiply this first term times 5 over 5. Okay, so the same concept. So minus, of course, 15 can be expressed as 3 times 5. So what's lacking value? Okay, we need 2. So we have 3 and 5, we need 2. So we will multiply this second term by 2 over 2. So if you notice, the denominator now has the same value, 2 times 3 times 5. This also 2 times 3 times 5. Okay? So 7 times 5 for the numerator, we can multiply that one since we are multiplying. So that is 35 over 30. Of course, 2 times 3 times 5 is 30. This one, 4 times 2 is 8. So over 30. So instead of 90, we are now using 30. So least common denominator. Okay, so we can now subtract the numerator since we have common denominator. So 35 minus 8 is 27 over 30. Of course, we can simplify further this rational expression. So 27 is 3 times 9. 30 is 3 times 10. Okay, canceled out the 3. So we have 9 over 10. So actually, we came up with the same result. But this time, we are using the least common denominator. This is the most efficient one, okay? The least common denominator. Okay, so let's apply this concept to the next exercise. So we have two terms, okay? We are asked to add this rational expression. Okay, so again, we cannot just add the numerator and denominator. So we need to find the least common denominator before adding. So how to find the least common denominator? Okay, we factored out the denominator. Let's say first, for the first term, 2x plus 2 can be factored out as, so we can mentally determine the factor, right? This is what? 2 times x plus 1. Of course, this is 2x, okay, plus 2, right? So that's the factor of 2x plus 2. Next, we'll factor out this denominator, x squared minus 1. This is what? Difference of squares. So this is a plus b times a minus b. Of course, this factor out to x plus 1 times x minus 1. So we have repeating value, x plus 1, x plus 1. So again, in least common denominator, we don't have to repeat that factor, which means the least common denominator is 2 times x plus 1 times x minus 1. And both of my terms must have this denominator, 2 times x plus 1 times x minus 1. Okay, so let's work out the first term, 3 over 2x plus 2. Okay, so 2x plus 2, okay, we factor out as this one, okay, 2x plus 1. So what's lacking? Again, my denominator must have this value. So 2 times x plus 1, what's lacking? The x minus 1. Which means I will multiply this term by x minus 1. Of course, both the denominator and numerator. Okay, so the same concept as before. Next, plus the second term. Of course, x squared plus or x squared minus 1. This is the factor. So what's lacking in this factor? We have x plus 1, x minus 1. We lack number 2. Okay, that means I will multiply this term 2 over 2. Right, so I have now common 2 times x plus 1 times x minus 1. So also 2 times x plus 1 times x minus 1. When I have common denominator, I can now add the numerator, right? But of course, before adding, so we are multiplying first. This is 3 times x minus 1 for the first term plus Of course, 5 times 2 is 10. So I have common denominator. Then I can add the numerator. Okay, so I have now 3 times x minus 1 plus 10. Of course, I simplified into a common denominator. 2 times x plus 1 times x minus 1. Then I will distribute. This is 3x minus 3. Okay, so negative 3 plus 10. That will give me 7. And that will be my final answer. 3x plus 7. So divided by 2 times x plus 1 times x minus 1. And this is the answer. Okay, so let's proceed to the standard form of quadratic equation. Of course, quadratic equation is a second degree polynomial equation. So the standard form is x squared plus bx plus c equals 0. Okay, so take note, we equate it to 0. A is the coefficient of x squared, b is the coefficient of x, and is the constant number. Okay, so take note of this format. Again, we equate to 0. Okay, so example, we are asked to find all the real solutions for the equation y squared equals 18 minus 7y. So to solve or to find the real solution for this one, the solution is to represent this in standard form, which means I will transfer this 18. I will equate to 0. So I will transfer this 18 to the left side. So positive will become negative. This negative 7y I will transfer to the left side. So it will become positive. So the standard form for this given equation is, okay, y squared plus 7y minus 18. To find the solution, we need to factor this out. And we know how to factor quadratic expression, right? So how to factor this out? Okay, we need to find the value of 18 and 7. Negative 8 or negative 18. This is the constant. This is the second term, 7. So we need to find two values that when we multiply will give us negative 18. When we add, will give us positive 7. So again, you can list all the factors of negative 18 and you will find this two number. So 9 and negative 2. So 9 times negative 2 is negative 18. 9 plus negative 2 is positive 7. So the factor of this quadratic equation is y plus 9 times y minus 2 equals 0. With this format, you can think that in order to find or in order to equate it to 0, which means one of this value or factor must be 0. Let's say y plus 9 times 0 is 0, meaning y minus 2 can be 0, right? Or another way around, this y plus 9 can be 0. Such that when you multiply y minus 2 times 0, it will equate to 0. So which means any of this factor can be 0. So let's try y plus 9. Y plus 9 can be 0, right? So if I transfer now my positive 9 to the right side, it will give me y equals negative 9. Okay, so that is one of the solution, but we need to check, okay, if that is really the solution. So we also have y minus 2, the second factor. Again, it can be 0. Okay, transfer this negative 2 to the right side. So we have y equals 2. So these are the two possible solutions, but not yet. Okay, so we need to confirm. So it must satisfy the equation. This equation. Okay, let's try first the negative 9. So we can substitute that value to the y. So negative 9 squared, right? Or that is your y squared equals 18 minus what? Okay, 7 times y. So 7 times negative 9. Okay, negative 9 squared, okay, this is positive, 81, so equals 18 minus, okay, negative 7 times negative 9 is positive, 63. 18 plus 63 is 81. So which means this one is the solution since it satisfied the equation. So next we'll test the value of y, which is equals to 2. So let's substitute the 2, okay, that is 2 squared, right, equals 18 minus 7 times 2. So 2 squared is 4, equals 18 minus 14. So 18 minus 14 is, okay, 4. So it satisfies the equation, which means y equals 2 is also the solution. So both of these values are the solution. Okay, there are cases that only one is the solution. Okay, so again, you need to check. So you need to verify that solution. Okay, so another exercise, we are asked to find all the real solutions for this given equation, w squared equals 121. Okay, so the process is to express this in standard form, which means this 121 will transfer to the left side. So from positive, it is now negative. And what is this format? This is difference of squares. 121 can be represented as 11 squared, right? So what is the factor in difference of squares? That is W minus 11 times W plus 11. So equals to 0. Again, one of these factor can be 0. So in order to equate to 0, this one can be 0, this one also can be 0. So which means W plus 11 can be 0, and this will give me, of course, negative 11, right? I will transfer this positive 11 to the right side, it will become negative. So W minus 11 also can be 0, so I will transfer this negative to the right side to become positive. Okay, so why I don't need to check this one? So obviously, if I have negative 11, I square that out, negative 11 times negative 11 is positive 121, the same with positive 11 squared also 121. I can just verify it mentally, okay? There's another method in solving this equation, and you have to take note of this. Whenever you have this squared in the left side, then you want to transfer that squared to the right side to become square root. Of course, square root can be positive or negative. So W square root of 121 is, of course, positive or negative 11. Okay, so we have two methods, but of course, this one is much easier. So take note, a squared from other side transferred to the other side of the equation, it becomes square root. Okay, so another exercise, okay, find all the resolutions for the equation. X times x plus 2 equals 7. Okay, so what we do first is distribute x times x, then 2 times x. So that is x squared plus 2x equals 7. Then equate to 0. So transfer that 7. We have x squared plus 2x minus 7 equals 0. Okay, what's next? Okay, we need to find two values that when we multiply will give us the constant negative 7. When we add, will give us 2. Okay, so can you think of that number? So actually, the only factor of 7 is 1 and 7. Or negative 1 and 7, or positive 1 and negative 7. And when you add that negative 1 and 7, it will give you 2. Okay? Which means the factor of this quadratic equation is not a whole number. It might be a rational number, which is a little bit harder if we are going to determine it manually. That's why we have this quadratic formula. Ideally, this is used if your factor is a fractional form or rational expression. But of course, you can also use this if your factor is a whole number. Okay? So this one is the solution to the quadratic equation. So given by this formula, you need to memorize this one. So the value of x is equivalent to negative b plus minus b squared minus 4ac over 2a. This one is called the discriminant, the square root of b squared minus 4ac. Okay, again, discriminant. So that's the term. Okay, so we'll be using that quadratic formula to this equation. So again, we cannot factor this out manually, but we will be using quadratic formula. Okay, so this is the standard form of this one, ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. Okay, so where's your a? Okay, the coefficient of x squared, which is 1. Your b is, of course, this 2. Your c is constant, negative 7. Okay, so that is your value of ABC. So we'll be using this formula. We can substitute the value to the given formula. Okay, so we have now x equals negative 2. Negative b. Okay, so take note we have that negative b is positive. But based on the formula, we have that negative already. Plus minus 2 times a. Okay, a is 1. Okay, 2 times 1. Okay, so square root of b squared. Of course, b is 2. Okay, b squared minus 4ac. Okay, your a is 1. Okay, a times c, which is negative 7. 1 times negative 7. Okay, so we have now 4 times 1 is 4 times negative 7 is negative 28. Right? But we have this negative sign, so which means it will become positive. So 2 squared, okay, 4 plus 28. So that is 32. Okay, so obviously 2 times 1 is 2. Okay, so square root of 32 is, or 32 can be represented as 16 times 2. Okay, so what's the rule for the radical? Okay, we can distribute the radical over E product. So this now square root of 16 times square root of 2. So square root of 16 is 4. Okay, so then we can divide this term. Negative 2 divided by 2 is negative 1. 4 divided by 2 is 2. Okay, so we have this value of x, negative 1 plus minus 2 square root of 2. Okay, so we have the values plus and minus. Okay, so this is the first value, negative 1 plus 2 square root of 2. And the second value is negative 1 minus 2 square root of 2. If you are going to factor this out manually, so a little bit harder, right? So that's why we need the quadratic formula. Quadratic formula can also be applied in any quadratic equation, even if the factor is whole number. Okay, so it still works. So take note of that. Okay, so another exercise. Find all the real solutions for the equation 1 half y squared equals 1 third y minus 2. Okay, so the process is to express this in standard form by transferring, of course, all the terms in the right side to the left side. So we have now 1 half y squared minus negative 1 third y. So your negative 2 becomes na positive equals 0. And I don't want this fractional coefficient. So I want to work with whole number. So what I can do is I can multiply both sides of the equation by 6. So which means I will distribute 6 times 1 half, 6 times negative 1 third, 6 times 2, 6 times 0, obviously that is 0. Okay, that is what I'm going to do. So first is 6 times 1 half will give me 3, right? Okay, next we have negative 1 third times 6, that will give me negative 2. Okay, 2 times 6, that is 12, of course. 0 times 6 is 0. So I removed that fractional coefficient now. So all coefficient is whole number. And for the quadratic formula, okay, we need to determine the value of ABC. Okay, this is your x squared minus BY plus C. Okay, so we have 3, negative 2, and 12. So we can plug that in the quadratic formula. Of course, you know how to plug this in, right? Okay, so this is your B, negative 2, for AC. So 3 times 12. Okay, 3 times 12. Okay, so actually, this term here under the radical sign, negative 2 squared minus 4 times 3 times 12 will give us negative 140. So square root of negative number. Okay, so let's define first what is a square root. Square root is you think of a number that when you multiply by itself, it will give you that number. Let's say the square root of 25 is 5, since 5 times 5 is 25, right? Or it can be also negative 5. Since negative 5 times negative 5, take note, both negative is positive 25. So how about negative numbers? Well, there's no way that you have the square root of a negative number. The solution for this one is imaginary number, not the real number. Which means for this given exercise, okay, there's no real solution for this one. The solution for this one is imaginary value. Okay, this is the end for this lecture in solving quadratic equations. So I hope you can follow along with the steps, although it's a little bit hard. My advice is you keep on practicing more problems to be very good at it. Again, I hope to see you in the next lecture.